Hey, there we go. Hello, everyone. Welcome to our spring-ish orchestra concert. Not quite spring, but kind of in the spring-ish semester. Quarter orchestra concert. So happy to have you all here. I don't have way too much to say tonight. Just a couple things here at the beginning, and then we're pretty much just going to run it down. Just first thing to say is this concert doesn't actually ever really happen. In the past, they have not had a concert in February or March. They've just kind of done the December one and then an end-of-the-year one. So this is a pretty big change, not only to mention because it's a new concert that's not normally done, but it's also like a month earlier than I tend to like a spring concert to be.
So it's a little bit precarious
in that it's a little bit earlier than normal, but your students have done just such a great job stepping up to the challenge, playing a lot of really, really difficult music, performing a lot. This is kind of a dry run for us for a festival that we have here at DM, 2 weeks from Wednesday, so 12-ish days away. The Symphonic Orchestra Parents, it's kind of like that festival we did last fall where we went down to Highland High School, but instead of going somewhere to do it, it's here. The students will perform in the morning and they get clinicked by judges and receive a rating based on how well they perform. So it'll be a really great experience. It's awesome that it's here because we don't have to actually drive anywhere. They just kind of do the thing here on stage, go to another room, and then get all of that valuable information without having to leave the building. So that's super great. The only thing, there are two things I want to mention before we start playing. One, the boosters are selling roses up top for $5 a rose if anyone would like to help. Contribute to the band and orchestra boosters. We had like $900 raised at our December concert, which is just super awesome. That pays for a variety of things. The soloists that we brought in last concert, we're getting hoodies for these guys, which is going to be great, free of charge, based on the money that we raise, which is awesome. And then second, I just want to bring a little bit of mention to the fact that both groups are doing something that I have never done before, and that I gave Friday, and they're performing it at the concert tonight. That being said, it's not like the craziest, most difficult thing in the world to let them crash and burn and have a fun experience. Haha, this is what it's like to suck. No, it's pretty easy music. The piece this group is performing, it's the first thing on the program, is a grade one, which is music I give to fifth and sixth graders. So they pretty much write it down. But the really nice thing about it is that whenever we give them new music, I like to give them challenging music because you only get better by being challenged. Which means that in an 8-week rehearsal cycle, we tend to save all of the actual music making and not just the, okay, this is still an A-flat. It's always been an A-flat. It's not going to change. It's been that way for 200 years. We save a lot of the music making as far as like a lot of the finer techniques that they have to do until like the last 3 or 4 weeks. Nice thing about this is day one, this is music that they can play immediately. And they get to actually work on all of that extra stuff. So it's really nice just playing a really beautiful but simple piece really, really well. And it's actually something I'm probably going to keep doing in the future. The other orchestra is doing that as well. They're playing Jupiter from the Planets. A little more difficult, but still pretty sight readable. So look forward to those pieces. I hope you enjoy the concert. Your students are playing very, very well, and I'm so proud of them and can't wait to hear the beautiful music that they make.
Thank you. Thank you.